Hi friends, today we are going to take up the topic framing questions. Questions are very, very important in our life because if we want to know anything from somebody, we have to ask a question. And we know some information, still we have doubt. Then we pose a question to get confirmation. And sometimes even we have alternative answers. Even for that, we have to pose questions. In this way, questions are very, very important. For example, where are you going? If I ask somebody, he will tell, I am going to such and such place. So that is the answer he gives. Suppose the question is not clear and it is not understood by the other person, the answer will not be clear. The answer will be confusing. So asking a question correctly is very important. And also, asking a question at the right time, right question is also very important. See, irrelevant questions at the unimportant times, they will not give you proper answer, clear answer. Furthermore, there may be some confusion, there may be some mess, even irritating situation may be created at the time. So, proper question at the right time is very important to get correct answer or required information. And answers from the other side always depend on the questions we pose to them. When we pose relevant question, you get relevant answer. Suppose you want to know what is the purpose of that work. You ask, suppose, why are you doing like that? Suppose the person is very busy in doing something, he may be irritated. He may be irritated with that question, so you may not get correct answer. Because that work is very important for him at that time. You are an outsider, you pose that question, why are you doing like that? Why are you doing that? So that is irrelevant to him. And that work is important. This interference is unimportant. So that is irrelevant at that time. So notable thing is that we should be aware of the things and circumstances while posing question. And asking a question is a skill. See, asking a question is a skill means, so you should ask the question in a proper way and the question should be relevant to the situation. That is a skill. Asking a question correctly is an art. See, asking a question is a skill and asking a question correctly is an art. When we know this, we can easily move and cope up with all the situations, with the people and everything. So today we go into the topic to know how to frame questions and how many kinds of questions are there. Kinds of questions. There are four kinds. One is informative questions or WH questions. Second one, yes or no questions.
Third one, alternative questions. Fourth one, tag questions. Informative questions. These questions start with a WH word like who, what, how much, etc. These WH questions are totally 14. Suppose you pose a question with any of these 14 WH words, that is called informative question. These informative questions need information as response. That means yes or no answer is not sufficient for this. So these questions can't accept yes or no as answer. For example, where are you going is a question posed. Suppose you say yes. Is it suitable answer? No, it looks very silly. Suppose you say no, it is also not correct. So it needs some information where you are going. It may be in one sentence or more than one sentence. The answer should be like that. Why are you depressed? You have to explain the reason for your depression here, but you can't say one word answer yes or no. In the same way, third one, how is your granny now? That means you should say yes, she is okay, she is recovering, something like this you have to answer. When will you go to Bangalore? When will you go to Bangalore? So that means you should say a certain time when you plan to go. In this way, informative questions start with any of 14 WH words and they need required information in a relative information in a specific way. That is informative question. And the second one, yes no questions. These questions will have a simple answer like yes or no. See that response is only one word, yes or no, that's enough, unlike informative questions. And also formation of these questions also somewhat different. These questions start with an auxiliary verb and there will not be any WH word in these questions. See that, are you coming with me now? Are you coming with me now? Or is a helping verb. It needs the answer. If you want to say yes, then you can say yes, I am. When you want to say no, then you can say no, I am not. So this is the answer we have to give as a response to these yes or no type questions. See that your answer should not be like this. Suppose, are you coming with me now? Yes, I am not. That is wrong answer. Because yes is the positive answer. I am not, again negative. How can you combine these two? So the answer cannot be positively negative. It should be either positive or negative. That's all. In the same way, a negative answer cannot be like this. No, I am. No is negative. I am is positive. So these kind of answers are not suggestible for these questions. And see the second one. Did he reach the place? Did he reach the place? The question started with did, auxiliary verb. we just say yes he did or no he did not for negative answer. But you can never say yes he did not, no he did. These are wrong answers. So in this way, yes or no type questions are only in one word answer. They require one word answers, yes or no, in the proper way. You can easily find out the difference between informative questions and yes or no type questions in framing question. See, it is everything the same in yes or no type question as informative question, but it is only without WH word. Suppose you remove WH word in the informative questions, all will become yes or no type questions. Observe it. The first question is that, where are you going? Remove where, WH word, then it becomes a yes or no type question. Are you going? Then you can say, yes, I am. Otherwise, no, I am not. It has become yes or no type question when you remove WH word. In the same way, second one, why are you depressed? Remove why, WH word, then it becomes a yes or no type question. Are you depressed? Then you can say, if you are depressed, say yes answer. Otherwise, no answer. Is your granny now? Is your granny now? It is somewhat silly, but is your granny okay now? Is your granny okay now? Is the yes or no type question when you remove how from there. In this way, there is some similarity, just likeness is there between informative questions and yes or no type questions. So let us move on to the third one, alternative questions. The title itself tells, alternative means either this or that. The question will have this alternative answer in it. So these questions may offer alternatives, and those alternatives are connected with the word or, or are. And response for these questions may be any one of the alternatives or both, and sometimes none of the two. You may go for some other alternative, some other word for your answer, as your answer. For example, we see them. Is your college near or far? Near or far, alternative is there. You can say, my college is very near. Or you can say, my college is very far. This is the answer, but you cannot say yes or no. Okay. And go for the second one. Are you married or single? Are you married or single? You can say, I am married, if you are. Otherwise, I am not married, I am single. Okay. And in this way, has he reached Hyderabad or not? Is she a doctor or actor? You can say a doctor if she is, or actor. Or otherwise, you can omit these both answers, both alternatives, and go for another one. No. She is not a doctor, not an actor, not an actor. She is just a lecturer, you can say. In this way, alternative questions may have answer in them, or another answer for them. Now, let us move on to the fourth type. Tag questions is the last type in framing questions. Tag questions
are not like regular questions as a informative questions and yes or no type questions, or even alternative questions. These are very, very simple and small. These questions always attach to a statement or a sentence. So, these are called confirmation questions, because see, a statement is informative. Based on that information, we pose a question. For example, he is a student. Isn't he? That isn't he is the tag question. Isn't he is understood only when the statement is before it. Otherwise, that question is not understood. For example, you directly say, isn't it? What is isn't it? What can you make out? No. He is a student. Isn't he? Then it is understandable. Then you say, yes, he is. Yes, he is a student. That is the response we get from isn't he, when only it is attached with the statement. So, it is said a confirmation question. And these kind of questions are mostly used only in conversations, not in written English, because conversation is only for our understanding. Even when you speak in broken language, we can understand, it is okay. Written English is legible. So, mostly these are not used. And we understand these confirmation questions or tag questions very clearly by the following examples. You are a student, aren't you? Is the question tag here. In the second one, you are not a bad student, are you? Is the question tag. Underlined part, are you? Is the question tag. And in the third sentence, he is my friend. Isn't he? Is the question tag. She will listen to you. Won't she? Is the question tag. In all these four sentences, we see that underlined part is called tag question or question tag. When you observe closely, the tag question has maximum 3 words, minimum 2 words. See, in the first example, there are 3 words. Are, not, you. In the second one, are, you. So, we say that a tag question is always part of the statement. It consists of maximum 3, minimum 2 words. And you can observe one more point here. When the statement is positive, the tag question is negative. That is in the first example and third example. You are a student, positive statement. So, tag question is a negative, aren't you? In the third statement, third example, he is my friend, positive statement, isn't he? that is negatively tagged question is formed. When the statement is negative, the question tag is always positive. That you can see in second example. You are not a bad student. Are you? So question tag is positively formed. This is because we should get our confirmation as per the statement given, as per the information given in the statement. When you say you are a student, aren't you? Then we get the answer, yes, I am. Yes, I am a student, like that. So, you are not a bad student, are you? No, I am not a bad student, like that. For this purpose, tag question is formed based on the sentence or statement. Formation of these tag questions depend on three rules mainly. The first one is locate or identify the helping verb in the statement. That is the first rule. In the next rule, see that the statement, when it is given positively, you should form the tag question negatively. When the statement is given negatively, the tag question should be formed positively. That means including or not, or not including it is important. It is the second point. As a third point, you should take only the pronoun of the subject in the given statement. And let us observe these three rules by the examples given below. Ramesh is a lawyer. In this sentence, as per the first rule, helping verb in the statement, it is is. So write it, and then statement is a positive, so tag question is a negative. Add the word not, then you go for the subject in the statement, that is Ramesh. Ramesh is a noun, but we don't take the noun as it is in the question tag. The substitute word for Ramesh, that is he, is taken. This is the third rule, and noteworthy rule this is. So the tag question is isn't he. In the same way, the second sentence, Raju and Hari are friends. In this statement, are is the helping verb, and the statement is positive. So we want the tag question negatively, aren't, and the substitute word for the subject, that is Raju and Hari, two are there, so they is the substitute word. Aren't they is the tag question. And in the third example, they were not coming to college. In this statement, a tag question is were they, only with the two words. This is because were is the helping verb in the statement, and the statement is negative, so the tag question is a positive. And the subject word, subject is they pronoun itself. So we take that pronoun as it is, were they. In the same way, fourth example also tells that the tag question, does he, for the statement, because does he is the helping verb there and it is a negative. The subject word is already a pronoun. So does he is the tag question for that. Here is a note. The important note is that sometimes in statements auxiliary verb will not be present. At the time you should take the appropriate do form by seeing the principal verb. For example, the principal verb when it is in present form, you should take the auxiliary verb do. When the principal verb in yes form, you have to take a does. When the principal verb in past form, you have to take did. Appropriate do form is did for the past form of a principal verb. So in this way we should take these helping verbs when helping verb is not present in the given statement to form tag question. When helping verb is not present, we have said that do form should be taken, appropriate do form should be taken, that is based on the principal verb present in the sentence. See, the first example, Seema sings well. Sings is the main verb. It is in present form. So, does is present in that main verb, the principal verb. So, we start with the does and the statement is a positive. So, we form this tag question negatively. Doesn't. And Seema is a noun, but we take its substitute word she. So its question tag is doesn't she. In the same way, in the second sentence, he went to college. Went is a principal verb, main verb. It is in its past form. So we take a did. In all past form verbs, appropriate do form is a did. So we take did and the statement is a positive, we form it negatively, tag question is negatively, and the subject is already it is a pronoun, so we take it as it is. Did not he, didn't he. And in the third sentence also, paint is the principal verb in which do is a present, so the tag question is don't you. In this way we take do forms, appropriate do forms, when auxiliary verb is not present in the statement to form tag questions. And another important point here you have to remember is, when you write a tag question, it should be in the contracted form. We have already learned contracted forms of auxiliary verbs. Is not, isn't, do not, don't, was not, wasn't, like that. So here we write all contracted forms in tag questions. Writing tag questions in contracted form is very, very good. In the worksheet, we have two bits. The first one, to frame questions to get the following answers. So how you frame questions to get these answers. The first one, I play quite well. I play quite well. How can we ask this question? How do you play? How do you play? For the second one, yes, I would love to meet him.
When you find yes or no in the beginning of the statement, you can easily imagine that it is yes or no type question. So, would you love to meet him? Is the proper question for it. In the same way, third one, my college is about 10 kilometers from home. My college is about 10 kilometers from home. What may be the question asked to get this answer? How far is your college from home? Is the question. How far is your college from home? The fourth one, I work in the university. What may be the question for this? The right question is, where do you work? Where do you work? And fifth one, she likes classical dance. She likes a classical dance. What may be the question for this answer? Which dance she likes? Which dance does she like? So like this. Like this, you can go for more practice. In the second bit, you should go for the right tag questions for each of the sentence. English is my favorite subject. Isn't it? Isn't it? See, is the helping verb there. The statement is positive, so we form the tag negatively. Not should be there in the tag. And English is the noun there. So, substitute word for English is it. Isn't it? The second statement, Radhika can act in any role. Can is the helping verb. And statement positive, so tag question should be negative. Can't. Radhika is subject, so substitute word for Radhika is she. Can't she? Is the right question tag. Third one, he did not understand well. This is a negative statement. And the helping verb is did. So, did he? Is the question tag. My friend will play in the IPL. Will is the helping verb here. And there is no negative word in the statement. So, won't he, my friend means he, substitute word. And fifth one, she retired last month. Retired, there is no helping verb in the statement. So, go for the principal verb that is in the past form. In the past form verb, appropriate do is did. So, take did. The statement is a positive. So, we form the tag question negatively, did not. She is there in the place of a subject. It is a pronoun. Take it as it is. Did not she? Didn't she? Is the right question tag for this. In this way, you can practice from some other source and understand in a better way. Friends, I hope you have got some clarity over this topic, framing questions. This is only on the surface. This is not complete on framing questions, just an outline. Based on this, I hope you can make more work to understand it thoroughly. Thank you for watching this topic, this video, and let us meet in the next video with a new topic.